My topic is, the topic they gave me is cutting the cost of governance. And I don't want to talk about federal government. Other experts will talk about them, but let me talk about where I serve, the subnational government. The out of this 11.4 trillion expenditure expected this year, the states are 5.4. And I believe that this 5.4, we can save at least a trillion. At least they won't borrow it because it's going to be borrowed. We can save a trillion. And people will say to me, how are you going to save it? How? One, I always say it. Out of this so-called 5.4 trillion, 12 to 15% is used in running the office of the governor, including the so-called controversial security vote, AIDS, everything takes almost between 12 and you're looking at about 600 to 800 billion. Thereby, I want you to listen to me. Thereby, if you decide to reduce it to 3 to 5%, it will be between 200 and 300 billion. You save at least 450 to 600 billion. That's a saving of 450 billion. If you decide to do proper procurement, competitive procurement that is competitive, you save as much as the same amount. So with these two, you've saved almost 900 billion. If you decide to do away with the unconstitutional office of First Lady, it's very unconstitutional and has a lot of confusion to the what is happening. It costs an average state today about 2 billion to run that office. And all the office does is create confusion. So if you do away with it, as 2 billion average in a state, you have saved additional to 2 billion, which is 72 billion naira. Add it to our 900, we have 970. If you decide today, the average, most states have about an average of 6 bulletproof vehicles. Today is about 100 million naira for one. And if you times 6, 100 million today, times 6, then times 36, it comes to about 21.6 billion. But if you reduce it to 2, it will be about 7.2 billion, and you save about 14 point something billion. If you decide, the average government house have about 27, 25 jeeps. Today's price is about 35 to 40 million. So you're looking at an average of, if you use 35, it's 875 million naira each, multiplied by 36. Again, if you reduce it from 8, 25 to 8, you save about 15 billion. We don't need dispatch rider or whatever these people that create a lot of noise. You don't need that machine. You can go without them. Each of those machines, each of those machines costs about 12 to 15 million naira. And I can tell you, most states have about 6, 7, 8 of them. If you do away with them, you will find out that it's at another savings of probably 3 billion naira. Traveling. 1 minute. Traveling. Every government house or governor can tell you the number of traveling budget, logistics, the collectors of name is almost 500 to 600 million. I believe you can do with, if you times again 600 times 36, I believe you can do all your travels for a third of that. You save 115. So if you look at what I've showed you now, you're going to save over 1 trillion. And I can tell you it is practical. People will say to me, Peter, how is this possible? How is it not possible? My idea was the governor. When I came to office, When I came to office, my first four trips to Abuja, I traveled with over 30 people. Over 30. Everybody have a title to be in the plane. Everybody have a title to do this. So, wait a minute. I'm the only person invited to Abuja. I pay for 30 people who have no reason to be in Abuja. They constitute a problem to the traveling public. They follow me to Abuja. I'm the one who is going to go to a meeting. Because the idle and the hotel, they eat more. So I have a lot of bills to pay. In the end, every trip was costing me over 10 million. One trip. And at times I do this 4 or 5 times in a month. So after about the third or fourth trip, I sat down and said, I want you to write name of everybody from me and tell me why and what is the purpose of this person going to be in Abuja. And what did they do? What happened? What did they do? When they finish, I found out the only person that needs to go to Abuja is me. So I said to them, leave it, because some of you must have heard Peter Obi travels alone. No, because the other people, I don't need them in Abuja. I give you an example. If I had taken police from Waka to Abuja, there might be about 12, 20, 15 security men. And each time I go, let me use today's pricing. One ticket one way is about 30,000. Coming back is 30,000. I found out that I can talk to the IG then, Onovo. I said, Onovo, when I'm in Abuja, give me 3 policemen. The other person, give me 2. When I'm going, I give them 5,000, which is not up to the ticket of one person going. I said, give two people. So nobody followed me to Abuja. 1 minute, because my time is going, you know. Nobody followed me to Abuja. So when I come, the people say, hey, Peter Obi is traveling on his own, he's carrying his bag. I'm a young man, I can carry my bag. What is the proposition? You know? And I told them, I said, listen, this is not a problem I started from here. I had this problem while I was in the bank. So I know, and I'll tell you that experience. So I said, that stopped. The house had to question me at the end of, there was a time they wanted to go to what they called the World Igbo Congress in America. And they showed me that somebody before me had gone with 40 million. And they said they reduced my own, it's 32 million. I said to the PAMSEC, can you write me what this implication of this, the Anambra State? Nothing. He just kept telling me, they have reduced it. I said, no. Well, let one person go. Whatever the Igbos in America discuss, they can tell us by this thing. When I changed, we came to the government house. When I started being a governor, no permanent secretary in Anambra State had a car. The judges didn't have a car. And meanwhile, there's in the budget provided there, there's a 150 million naira for the government to buy 2 bulletproof cars for the governor. I said, okay, fine, it's good. I took it, called one Mr. Eric, who was then the GM of PAN, with Onyemuche Namani, and said, listen, I want you people to do me a favor. I want to buy, they used to sell Peugeot 406, 3.7 million. I said, I want to buy about 100. So you sell it to me, 3 million. The Frenchman agreed with me, so I took the 150, gave him a deposit. He gave me the first 50 vehicles. I had 18 judges, so 18. I had permanent secretaries, 19. The governor will keep 10. So all my first tenure, if you are around Dorka, I used 406 Peugeot. And nobody kidnapped me, nobody shot me, and we saved that money. We had, some of you might have I was removed from office twice, because he was talking about sharing money. And I can tell you why I was removed from office. It's all part of this. When I was starting, Anambra State government house was burnt. Because when I say where we are going to save money, I want to tell you how we saved it and how we were able to be the only government that left and didn't borrow money from anybody. Instead, saved. When Anambra State, in 2004, the Anambra government governor's house was burnt, the government governor's lodge, as well as the government house. Coincidentally, in 2006, when I started, the budget to repair the government house was 298 million. To repair the governor's lodge was 481 million. These are the two reasons why I was impeached. The third was saving money without permission. And I said to them, wait a minute. I repaired everything in the government house, which is governor's office. I repaired everything with 43,200,000. The only thing I didn't buy new, the only thing I didn't buy new was furniture. Because there's a table used by one of my predecessors that was kept somewhere, and they say it's old. But I called the man, the furniture man, and said, if you wipe this seat, who deep in it? I just want to say you're right. Where's it to buy a new one? Why are we buying a new one? The governor's lodge. The governor's lodge, I had a point. I want you to tell, I'm no longer the governor, so these are things you can verify. The governor's lodge, which was a budget of 486 million, I repaired everything with 81,700,000. In both of them, because the contract was awarded before I came, they said I did it without passing through the due process. Because I have awarded the contract. And I said no. Obasanjo as president, because one of the things that I did is that we had a governor's lodge in Lagos. We had a governor's lodge in Abuja. We had almost 60 workers in Abuja. And I asked them, why will governor of Anambra State have a lodge in Lagos? Why will he have a lodge in Abuja? Does he live in Abuja? What is he doing in Abuja? You know what they wrote me? Every other government have it. I said, that's not what I asked. Why are we having to have a lodge in Abuja? I don't live there. Each time I go to Abuja, the cook there, we will need to give him about 30,000 to cook. And I say, cook, you're going back to Oka. It costs 5,000 naira to eat buffet at Hilton, and you charge me 30 here. So what are you cooking here? You must go back to Oka. You know. And people say, people will tell me, oh no. People will say, hey, wait a minute. I said, cook, you must go. I shut down, as I lived at our governor's lodge here for 25 years, shut down our governor's lodge in Abuja. Everybody said to me, Peter, you can't do without governor's lodge. I didn't have one for 8 years because it was not necessary. I told everybody who was there, we had almost 15 drivers in Abuja. When I'm at the airport, everybody's there, because creating confusion. I said, listen, we need 3 drivers in Abuja. The rest will either have to go and look for work or come to Oka. We don't live in Abuja and everything. And this, Obasanjo wanted to come to Anambra State. Every state you go today, they have what they call presidential lodge. And they said, we have started building one for almost half a billion naira. I stopped it. Obasanjo wanted to come to Anambra State. And they said, I went to them and said, listen, tell Mr. President, he can come in the morning and go in the evening. We don't need him to sleep. One, we don't need him to sleep. They said, no, 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 no. They said, no, 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 he must sleep. He must sleep. I said, okay, let's not worry about it. I went to him. The other day, I'm telling you what's that. I went to him, he came in October end of October 2006. I went to him, I said to the chief of staff, I said, tell him please, he can come in the morning. He said, no, he must sleep, he's doing this. I said, okay, no problem. I called his people, say, since he cannot stay in a hotel, and he must sleep, come and see where I live. This is where I live. If this place is okay for him, I will give you the key for 1 month. Then I will go. When he goes, they were very nice to me. I can tell they were very nice. They said to me, we need it for only 1 week. So I came back and told my dear wife. She's the only one who has property there. I said, bring out your thing. The president is going to sleep in this room. This room. We are going to give them the key. I went across to a hotel called Pactonia. The man charges 30,000 per suite. For that 1 week, you know how much he charged me? 100,000. That is what I would have spent, 500,000. So Obasanjo came on Thursday, stayed Thursday, Friday, Saturday, he left. They gave me back my key. And I spent 500 million, which I would have used to do the lodge. I would have been maintaining it by now. So Anambra State does not have a presidential lodge because the president doesn't live in Anambra State. He lives in Abuja. They said, they told me that I don't have, they wanted a car. They said to me, oh, you must have a treated car, a bulletproof car that the president and his people can use. I said, I don't have. Bring your motor here. All I will tell you is that I will not, if you want that, I will enter it. But I will not, I don't have anything. They argued and argued and argued. Luckily for me, I have a neighboring state that bought that type of car. I said, okay. I'll go to this state and ask them to bring their car here. When you people go, they carry their vehicle. I don't have, and I won't buy it. What am I trying to say? You can do all this. You can save all this money. There's so much waste in our system, and we all tolerate it. People tell you today, add people. Yes, I quarreled with people. People who said they come and do courtesy call. That was what I was telling Prof. I was quarreling with people. Somebody said he wants to do courtesy call. He wrote me a letter. As he's going, my protocol people come say, hey, or this bishop or this chief, welcome now. I said, what? He said, we'll give him something. I said, huh? The man just said he wants to see me. Did I ask him to come? Why are we going to give him money? Get out of this place. The man wants to see me. And he wants to see me, and that's it. So for us, what is more important for us? We have a government, we said, we have to plan to turn things around. What are we going to do? We adopted what we call the MDG goals and said we'll go on these goals and implement it. From all these monies we're going to save, whether it is, if you talk about security vote, oh, this is the percentage, this is this. That's how we started to do statistics to fight poverty. And what did we discuss when we did poverty mapping? That the poorest areas in Anambra State, their problem was access. And I can say to you, go to Anambra State today. We have the best road network of any state in this country. And then we look at it, we went into education. Everybody knew that education was shut down in Anambra State for 2 years. Under a particular government, we said, when I started, we were number 26 in WAEC. I said, no, we must be among the first 10. How are we going to do it? We looked at it and said, okay, the best thing is to return these schools to the church. It belongs to them. And we'll give them money directly. And everything, of course, oh, that was very difficult. Everybody wanted to collapse the whole place. I said, well, you know, my wife will always come back and say to me, Peter, hey, this is you're doing. Do you know people are not happy? These people are not, why are you always making trouble? These people are not happy with you. This, that, and everything. And I'll always tell them, I said, listen, my dear wife, I have one of the most wonderful wives anybody will wish. I will always say to her, listen, Margaret, your problem is that you don't understand. My job is not to make people happy. There's people in the entertainment industry to make people happy. My job is to take the right decision. It's not my job. My job is not to make people happy. My job is to take the right decisions for the benefit of the people. I'm telling you why I was impeached. The only reason why I was impeached is that I was saving money. I said, listen, this is the only country in the world that has a diminishing assets called oil, and they're not saving money. Every other country has it as a law that a portion of this money must be saved. So I said in Anambra State, we must save. It is a critical thing, we must save. And I talk about it when we went to education, I said, I don't want money again to be given to the Ministry of Education. Money must go direct to government from our purse to the church. They went and reported to the federal government because their money was involved. Of course, federal government set up a panel which came headed by Governor of River State today. I said, money should not be given to ministry because I saw that there are so many toll gates that will stop the money from being spent. Give it to the church. When they came and showed them, this is church school, this is our own. Our own was not working. But what happened? In less than 3 years, 2011, 12, 13, Anambra was number one in WAEC and NECO. All this was possible because of the change we brought. We started saving money. Everybody will tell me, say, Peter, why are you keeping this money? Why are you doing this? Let me give you the instance. Today, Anambra remains the most financially stable state in this country. If you don't know, the day I left government, 17th of March, 2014, I had in Access Bank, a bank in Nigeria, $50 million. I repeat, $50 million and about 7 billion naira. It's a bank in Nigeria. I'm sure Access Bank people are here. You can go and verify. I have in Fidelity Bank, a bank in Nigeria, $55 million, $55 million and over 10 billion naira. I had in Diamond Bank, a bank in Nigeria, $50 million. What I had the day I left was $155.4 million. By yesterday, in terms of the yield, because we called it future generation money, and was supposed to terminate at 2050. By yesterday, it was worth $185 million. If you multiply today, that is about 500. Because when you hear that Peter Obi left 75 billion, if anybody doubts it, call me. I know where the money is. I kept it. And on that day, and I said, on that day that I left, as of December 2013, I did not owe any teacher, anybody at the local government level, gratuity. As of the day I left, anybody in the civil service was not being owed gratuity or pension or salary, and no contractor had a certificate that is pending. I was one that bought the highest number of vehicles as a governor from PAN. It's there, they gave me a certificate from Kaduna. I started Innocence Factory. When Innocence came to Anambra State, I laid the foundation of Innocence Factory, and when it was completed, I brought President Jonathan to commission it, and there and there, ordered from him 1,000 vehicles. That 1,000 vehicles, how did I do it? About 600 and something was vehicles for schools. Every single secondary school in Anambra had a bus. Then all the security, all the communities, I bought one pickup for them. All of them, the traditional, I bought one. When I was buying, people say, hey, this is innocent. It just started. Do we know whether his car is good? Maybe the brake is not working. Maybe I said, don't worry. Let the number of people that will remain after the other ones die, leave. Let it kill the number of people. That's how that industry is working today. And nobody has been killed. Not one person. And that factory is functional. We went on, and if you see the cost implication, if we had bought foreign vehicles versus innocent, just like if you see the foreign implication, when people come to me and say, we are going to furnish, like when I was rebuilding the house, we are going to the, we say, hey, this furniture shop in Awolowo Road, this one, I say, listen, if we cannot find anybody to do governor's bed in Naka, then the governor will sleep on the floor, forget it. There must be a furniture man here that will give me furniture in Oka that will sleep. That's how we brought one Mr. Daja. I used to know him as a small boy. His company has collapsed. I called him and said, listen, you still know how to do furniture? I said, yes. I said, go and do all the bed that is here. Whoever can sleep in it can go and sleep somewhere else, not there. Why am I saying all this? All these things people tell you, this country today can still function on our income and be able to save money. And that brings me to where all of you are guilty. Because yes, I would have agreed with the lady that talked about this, about you. Yes, there's the one way you, but you cannot do anything if you have the type of leadership this country has experienced in several years. We are lost a case of where lunatics took over the asylum. And we must do something about it. You know, we must do something about it. Our leaders have to do what? We need to question their commitment, and that is where you come in. This is the only country we vote people in. They don't have a car. They don't do anything. 6 months, they invite us for housewarming, to wash their car. Instead of calling police, because we know where the money came from, we are busy dancing. Everybody is guilty of it. I have been in a church where I know somebody stole money. And the bishop is saying that wherever he got it from, may he multiply. The man is a thief. The man is a thief. He's a thief, so we should arrest him. He cannot multiply because he's stealing our money. People cannot continue. If anybody in government comes to tell you, everybody have good story to tell. If anybody see you, you write the paper, I've done this road, go to the road. I built a university from the scratch. It's in Ibarian. I built a teaching hospital from the scratch. It's in Oka, the fastest one. So let people say where they did it. Don't tell us in pages of newspaper. Don't give us our words. We want to know. If you say we want to export rice, let's eat the rice first. Let's have it. So all this is for you to take back the government. That is where I join Olisa in asking you. You can be the change. Stop celebrating criminality. Let us say, we cannot allow these people. It is your future that I are toying with, including me. We've wasted your time. People are talking about Bill Gates. Steve Jobs. 1 minute. Let me tell you. 1 minute. Let me tell you. If any of them is here, let me tell you, if they were here, they will succeed. Put me anywhere. One minute. I went to school. I've been to the best of schools. I've been to Oxford. I've been to Cambridge. I've been to all of them. And I tell you what. How many have you ever seen anybody in this country who walked into the bank and was given money based on intellectual capital? They will tell you to bring your grandmother's house, your father's old house, your grand. By the time you finish it, that's it. Bill Gates was given $1 million. Go and read the history of Microsoft by a bank. For a young boy who was in a garage. Steve Jobs and his friend Wozniak was given $2 million. Who would have given them that type of money here? Nobody. Let me tell you, Steve Jobs went and brought John Scully. John Scully was the CEO of Pepsi. Steve Jobs sent him a text and continued to send him a text. Do you want to continue selling sugared water or do you want to be part of changing the world? One day, John Scully got up and said to Pepsi, where is president and CEO? I'm leaving this company. I want to go and join these small boys in a garage. Which person will do it here? His people will say that they don't do a medicine. No. Nobody will do it. That's what we have. The government will not support you. You do anything here, the government will not patronize you. They will not patronize a white man. They will not do it. So there are so many things we take against. That is where a journalist had to say, let us take it back. Let nobody tell you there's not enough money. No. Tell me what a governor in Nigeria needs a dispatch rider for. What for? If I tell you how we stop fuel, we used to have a fuel dump when I was governor. Fuel dump. It was costing us almost 30 million a month. I said, what is it? They said, hey. I said, shut it down. I found out that my convoy in the first 2 weeks, because it was about 22 vehicles, was costing us about 300,000 to buy fuel. Of course, they know what happens to half of it. So I said, okay, you know what we're going to do? Bring down the convoy. People in Anambra here, I don't use her. I asked them, carry this in and go. Pack it. My convoy is 5 vehicle. And you cannot buy fuel unless I'm inside the car. So I will pay them. No more. Wait a minute. I'm telling the youths that are here, it is your future that they are toying with. I have children, I have kids, I have 2 lovely children that are graduates. Somebody told me yesterday, he said to me, my friend Chida, we were going somewhere, and I was telling him about the text my daughter sent to me. I wish I read that type of text to you and you will understand. And somebody said to me, oh, I saw your son. That one was in Vietnam. He was going to run somewhere. He said he's going for interview for job. Peter, can't you give him a job? Peter, can't you do this? The boy doesn't even have. I said, none of my children have car. I was the only person who is governor and bank chairman. Not to them. Nobody elected them one. They have to look for a job. They have to do what they need to do. Take back your country. This country belongs to you. It is your future that they are toying with. You must take it back from them. It is not their country. And you must take it back from them. And how will you take it back from them? How will you take it back from them? When they invite you, go to your local government and ask the local government chairman, who receives 100 million naira every month? What does he do with it? He will tell you no problem, yet he's buying new Jeep. This is somebody who has never seen car in his life. He now uses Jeep. His wife has become first lady of the local government. You go everywhere, a convoy will pass you. They say it's first lady of the state. First what? This woman is like they used to tell me then, hey, Peter, you're not treating your wife fairly. Peter, you're not doing this. That this is this. I said, no. There's so many costs. If I tell you literally, if I have time and tell you cost of governance here, you won't be here. When I came back, when I started, we had about 10 governors' guest house. I said, what is governor going to do with this? I go to work in the morning and go back in the evening. I'll come back. My cook then will cook about food that about 50 people will eat. I said, what is this for? They were killing one cow every day. I said, what is this for? He said, Your Excellency, I'm doing it in case if you come back with people. I said, have you ever seen me come back here with anybody? So why are you cooking for the people? Any day people will come here, I will let you know. Cook for only one person. One person. Me. I said, don't do it. You know, I come from Anambra State. There's too many big men. Of course. Like I tell them, I said, don't allow any of them to come here. I don't have what it takes to entertain them. So what they do, they phone me, Peter, I want to see you. I come to your house in the evening. So I go to his house because there he will bring, his champagne, eat his fabulous food, and at times when I'm going, they will give me some to take back. Goodbye. But don't go to government house because government house is not a restaurant. It's not a place to drink champagne. A bottle of champagne today costs about 400,000, 500,000. That is salary of 20 people at 20,000. And you drink it with the public money. No, you can't do that. If you want to do that, you go to your house. So I said to them, no, this is government money. We brought down the cost of feeding governor. If I tell you where I brought it down from, to this place, I say, this will be enough. Don't worry about me. And I can go on and on. You can go and work with people. It's not anything. It's not any magic. Every flight I've taken in Nigeria as a governor was the economy. Reason is simple. If I come, they say, business class, 54,000. Other one, you go to internet, it's 19,000. Is it not just from Abuja to this for 40 minutes? Why will I pay additional 1,000? I said, no. I went to Yongsha Agura and said, your hotel in Abuja, can you give me this guy? He gave me 50%. So to sleep there is 30,000 naira. And I said, no. That is what people want me to go to another bigger hotel and stay for 250,000 naira. And people say, oh, Peter, is it? I said, well, I have a problem. If I sleep there and pay somebody 250, I will be awake. I wouldn't go to sleep. Because I think they've stolen my money. Because I would think they have stolen my money. So it is important that you understand our government, we need to shut down cost of governance. No state government needs a house in Abuja. The governor doesn't live in Abuja. They don't need all this. Nobody wants to kill you. I was governor for 8 years without a bulletproof car. I must tell you that I bought one, but I didn't use it, and nobody killed me. I was using Prado. They will say, hey, it's not balance, it's not this. Another thing they keep telling me, that government vehicles, because of the high traffic, is every 6 months. I say, wait, if you remove this car from here, because you know what they do? They take it into auction and sell. I say, no, this car is here for the time. We will use it. It's functional. What do people think you're doing to yourself? We must shut down. And people say, where did you get money? To say, where did you get money? We got those monies. We were owing gratuities and pension of people for 35 billion. We were able to pay it because we have to shut down everything. I said, this cannot happen. Nobody will ever tell you that you came to a party while I was governor for 8 years. It's not a party, it's not a nightclub. No, it's governor's lodge. When I finish, I go home. If anybody wants to dance, he goes to nightclub. That is his business. And I take it. So all I'm trying to say is that we can change. No visitor will put in a hotel if you have any value to offer. And go and check. We are number one in implementation of MDG. We got an award for it. I spoke at the UN. Go to European Union. We are number one in European Union while I was there. Why am I saying this? We were able to meet up every obligation. So my dear people, yes, it's good to stay here and feel bad and do everything, but let me beg you, you have no other country except this one. And only you can build this. If anybody is telling you, those people out there, they don't know you. They don't care about you. If they care, they will do things differently. You will see it in their behavior. You will see it in the way they do things, the way they feel, the way they move, and everything. In that, because they are doing that, what I beg you is that you must, like Olisa pleaded, get up and decide to join politics. Get up and decide to be part of it. The man who is leading revolution in Hong Kong is 17 years old. He's 17 years old. My dear people, the society we help them to abuse today will take his revenge on all of us tomorrow. Thank you and God bless you.